Let us guess. You've just finished putting your socks back on after they've been blown off from watching The Queen's Gambit. Don't worry, you're not alone. There's a reason it's one of the most watched limited shows on Netflix ever. But you can't help shake off that feeling that you've seen the cast somewhere, but where? They look so familiar, but you just can't seem to figure it out. Where on earth have you seen these actors before? Well, look no further, juicers. As always, we have all the answers to all your head-scratching questions right here. You know, we just had to find out everything we could about this big-brained cast, so we did what we always do, a little digging. So make sure to follow Rumour Juice for more, because these shovels don't pay for themselves, you know. Harry Mellon. Let's be frank here. It's not that you didn't like Dudley Dursley, you hated him. When Hagrid made a pigtail grow out of his backside when he ate Harry's cake, you couldn't help but rejoice. Oh wait, you didn't know this was the same actor who played Big D in the Harry Potter films? Whoops, that's our bad. We thought you knew. Guess that's a pretty big surprise, isn't it? For quite a while, fans weren't sure that they would ever see Harry Mellon's face again after the Harry Potter franchise was ended. And then, all of a sudden, over the last couple of years, his face has started to pop up in more films, garnering him more attention. Fans also can't help but notice that the actor has lost a lot of weight since his role as Dudley. What you might not know is that he actually began to lose the weight while filming the last few Harry Potter films. The actor looked so different that the director of Harry Potter debated having him recast because fans would no longer be able to recognize him. Thankfully, rather than recast Melling, they decided that he would wear a fat suit instead for the remainder of the films.
Yeah, because I lost quite a bit of weight at 18. And so when I came back to do the last film, they go, oh, God. So I had to be in a fat suit, which was kind of made after weeks and weeks and weeks of kind of experiments. And
I can now shed the child actor thing, like the fat, and start a new career, because no one sees me as Dudley. The actor recaptured audiences' attention when he was cast as a villain alongside the fabulous Charlize Theron. For most of the film, fans, no doubt, had their eyes squinted, staring at his face and wondering why this bad guy's face is so familiar. Finally, at some point during the film, probably near the end, it finally clicked. That's the guy who played Dudley! Melling made it very clear that he is no longer the child actor with the pigtail, but a serious actor ready to take on complex characters. In The Devil All the Time, the actor worked with Robert Pattinson, Bill Skarsgård, and Tom Holland in the heart-wrenching drama, where he performed the role of an unholy and corrupt preacher. Fans were extremely impressed by his outstanding performance.
Return, spirit! Resurrect! God!
Then we saw Melling in The Queen's Gambit, and for the first time ever, fans fell in love with him. He was no longer depicted as the bad guy, the villain, the bully. Nah, this time he was sincere and eager to please Harry Beltic that had fallen in love with Beth Harmon.
You've helped me realize something.
What?
That I don't love chess. No, it's okay.
There was no way around it. Fans couldn't help but feel for his character and want to see more of him. He even got his teeth fixed for her. If that isn't a declaration of love, we don't know what is. But before you think that the actor actually went to have his real teeth fixed, think again. They were fake teeth that he wore from the fourth episode onwards. Bet he had you fooled, though. That was a fantastic way of subtly changing me, basically. It literally changes the way you speak and where your face falls. Although the numbers aren't quite out there, audiences are sure that the actor is making a pretty penny from his role in Gambit. Let's just say that he could get a lot of people's teeth fixed with the amount of money he's taken to the bank. We think it's a fair assumption to think that Harry Mellon is here to stay, and there's no doubt that there are many, many, many fans that would thoroughly agree. He's made a comeback that audiences didn't know they needed, or even expected. But if his future roles are anything like his most recent work, well, all we can say is that we can't wait for more. Anya Taylor-Joy. She's got the biggest almond-shaped eyes, and ever since she gazed at the world through their screens, they were hooked. Again, you might have scratched your head a little when you saw her as Beth Harmon and wondered where you'd seen those great big eyes before. Well, that's what we're here for. After being cast in a few small roles in films and TV shows, some roles so small she wasn't even named in the credits, Anya was cast in the horror film The Witch. And even though she had no real professional experience as an actress, audiences were amazed by her performance. The actress explained that she didn't even know how to properly take direction or how many takes she would have to do to film a scene. She had never worked on a full feature film before and was clueless as to what to expect. When she worked on her next films, she described herself as a completely different type of actor. Anya even went on to get nominated for several awards, which she unfortunately didn't end up winning. Oh well, it's always an honor to be nominated, right? In 2017, with the release of psychological thriller Split, the actress finally got her career ball to start rolling. She starred alongside the ever-so-talented James McAvoy, and the film was a huge hit. By this time, it's alleged that the actress was making between $100,000 and $200,000 per project. Phew, who wouldn't take that kind of money to the bank? Although, it wasn't all dollar signs and good times for the young actress. She also had to learn how to accept rejection, which was extremely difficult for her at the time. Anya opened up about a painful rejection she had to face after she auditioned for the Disney film Maleficent. The role was of a younger version of Angelina Jolie, and even though she knew she looked nothing like the actress, she was still devastated when she didn't get the role.
And it was my first experience of like rejection, like true rejection, and it was to play the young Angelina Jolie in Maleficent, and it was Disney, which for me was like, oh my god.
I definitely cried for a very long time after that happened. Thankfully, she didn't have to cry for very long, because Anya was well on her way to becoming a household name. The Queen's Gambit practically catapulted the actress into a whole new level of fame. It's not confirmed how much the actress was paid for the show, but her net worth has shot all the way up to $3 million. So we can only imagine how much she raked in for her role as Beth Harmon. There's no stopping Anya now, that's for sure. She has a whole lot of up-and-coming projects for this year, and one of them might even be a musical. Is there anything that this woman can't do? Clearly not. While she admits that singing in front of crowds does make her feel a little nervous, she wants to push herself as a performer and try new things. Singing or no singing, all we want is more of Anya. Thomas Brodie-Sangster. When you saw his face on screen, what was the first thing you thought? Was it, how did Nanny McPhee let this kid out of her sight? Or did you maybe wonder if he and his true love Joanna ever had their happily ever after? Many were shocked to see the Love Actually star all grown up bearing a goatee, a cowboy hat, and a knife at his hip. Somehow, fans couldn't help but wish that he demolished them at a game of chess, and we can't blame them. His bad boy attitude in The Queen's Gambit is completely different from his usual innocent and charming boy with a gap-tooth smile. This might come as quite a shock to you, so you better hold on to your straw juicers. Are you ready? Thomas was 15 years old when he starred in Nanny McPhee in 2005. Crazy, right? Gambit fans were quickly taken aback to find out that the actor is in fact going to be turning 21 this year. So not only has he been given the gift of outstanding acting talent, he's also been blessed with an ageless face. But what has our favorite cowboy chess player been up to over the last couple of years? He's worth a banging $2 million, so he must be doing something interesting to pass the time. Other than swimming in a pool full of dollar bills, that is. Well, believe it or not, Thomas lives a pretty low-key life. He's featured in several films and TV shows over the last few years. You might remember seeing him in Maze Runner as Newt and in Game of Thrones as Jojen Reed. He also seems to be a pretty nice guy, too. He's said to believe in humanity and is determined to live a happy life and be kind to others. People can't help but feel a little surprised to see a child actor turn out so well, but all we can say is we can't wait to see more of Thomas because he's definitely recaptured the world's attention. We're sorry if some of this info made your wallet seem a little dusty, but we do hope that we were able to make you feel better now that you know where you saw all these actors' faces before. You weren't crazy, you just needed a little reminding, and that's what we're here for. As always, we do this for you, juicers.
As always, we are eager to see your opinion in the comment section below, and do tell us which topic we should cover next. Behind-the-scenes dramas of your favorite shows? Why did this seemingly perfect couple break up? How come this Hollywood hottie is still alone? Who holds the title of the most fan-friendly celebrity? Make your voice heard, and we at Rumour Juice will make sure you are never bored. Subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to tell your friends how cool we are.